Welcome. This video shows freight forwarders and NVOCCs how the Magaya Network helps send and receive information and logistics transactions with cargo agents efficiently and reduce time-consuming and error-prone data entry. We'll start with an overview of the Magaya Network, show you how to add your profile to it, search for others, and then send a complete shipment transaction. In summary, the Magaya Network is a community of Magaya users. If we take a look at the Magaya Network icon, we see community and messages. Let's first talk about community. In the community, you have company profile, search, and invitations. In the company profile, you can enter in all your information or click this button here to fill in the form with the company information. Your company information comes from File, My Company Info. Once you fill all this information in, you can upload it to the Magaya Network. This means your company profile will be available for all users to see. In other words, this is another way for you to advertise yourself. In order to find another Magaya user, click the search button, enter any details here, and then click on search. Below, you'll see a list of all the users for that selected query. If you would like to establish communication between yourself and another company on the Magaya Network, just select that company name and click the invite button. You can also click the info button to see more details about them. After you send out your invitations, click on the invitations button and you'll see the invitations that have been received and sent. You can use these buttons here on any invitation. Just select the invitation and, for example, you can accept or deny. This one's already been accepted. On the right hand side, we have the communication center. This lists your company, all the LiveTrack customers or users that you have online, and the different Magaya users that you have connected to. For example, this is one database that I connected to, and this is a user inside of it. Here's another one and another user. If I want to chat with them, I can just simply double click them and I get a session window. This works like an instant messaging program. I can type any information on the bottom and then hit send. If you notice, they responded. There are some other features here. For example, you can add an agent by Magaya Network ID or add them from the forwarding agent list. The forwarding agent list is found under your maintenance. If you click the preferences button, you can configure the communication center. Also note on the top, you have the Magaya Network button. If you click on this, the communication center will open up. Note that if you click the arrow next to the send button, you can also send files over the Magaya Network. This is a great way to send information between users. So now let's take a look at the messages folder. If you notice on the top, we have a send button, but it's grayed out. We can send warehouse receipts, shipments, and documents to other Magaya databases. What we'll need to do is go to the specific transactions and click the send button within those transactions. The email button allows you to email from anywhere in the system, including from documents such as warehouse receipts, from lists such as the warehouse receipt list, and even from shipments. For example, you can send houses or the master. All of the things that you send or email will go out of the outbox and ultimately out of the send. If you receive anything, it will be in your inbox. Examples of incoming messages could be online pickup orders from LiveTrack. If you notice, we're also connected with US Customs, Intra, Electronic Airway Bills, and ExpressLink, which is connected to FedEx, UPS, and USPS. All of the messages that are sent and received will also be found here. So now let's quickly look at some configuration options for the Magaya Network. Let's go to Maintenance, then Configuration. In here, there are many features that use the Magaya Network, so we'll go over the main ones for you. Let's first look at outgoing messages. In here, you can configure the email client, your file formats, and the Magaya Network settings. In this video, we'll have an example of an export shipment going to a destination agent. These two options here allow you to send income charges or expense charges to your destination agents if you'd like. This is normally used if your destination agent is part of your company. In other words, your destination agent has a Magaya database and you would like them to see the income and expense charges on your transactions. If the destination agent is a third party, you can disable this. Now let's look at incoming messages. All of these options here allow you to select the folders for your incoming messages. There's specific options for shipments and also for warehouse receipts. You can even define your acknowledgements and determine whether you want to save the charges or entities of incoming messages. For example, if your destination agent sends you a shipment, you can decide whether you want to save those charges or entities. In this video, we're going to set up a few options. For warehouse receipts, we'll enable warehouse receipts to be overwritten if we have created them and we receive updated versions from other Magaya Network users. We'll do the same thing for shipments and then click the Save button. So now let's look at sending and receiving warehouse receipts. Let's click on Warehousing, go to Warehouse Receipts, and here we can see our warehouse receipt. We can click the Send button, select the Magaya Network user, and then click the Send button. By clicking the Send button, we're electronically sending the warehouse receipt to their database. This means all they have to do is update the warehouse receipt and send it back to us. We can also choose to send this warehouse receipt by email. If we do it this way, we're just sending the document. Now let's go back to the community and ask them if they received the warehouse receipt. I'll type in the message and hit Send. They responded back quickly. If we look at our sent box, we can see that we sent the warehouse receipt. Now if we go to the inbox, we can see the warehouse receipt is here, but not saved yet. In order to save it, just right-click on it and click Save to Database. You can also do this by selecting it and clicking on the Actions button. Now when we go back to our warehouse receipts, we'll notice some information has changed. In this example, the Magaya Network user just updated the invoice number and the PO number. So now let's take a look at sending and receiving a shipment. Let's go to outgoing shipments, and in this example, we'll select this master. Notice this master has master level documentation and two houses. This master has charges, and each house has its own list of charges. In order to send this shipment, let's click on the master and click the Send button. Then select the Magaya Network user and click the Send button. Notice the following message is asking us if we want to set the shipment in transit. If you take a look at our shipment status, it says loaded. This means the shipment is still in our possession. Once the shipment is in transit, it's en route. So in this example, I'll just hit yes. Now the shipment is in transit to the Magaya Network user. Let's go chat with them by clicking the Network button and double-clicking their name. On the bottom, we'll type a message, and then click the Send button. In order for you to see what happens on the other side, we're going to show you the Magaya Network user that we sent the shipment to. This is the Destination Agent database. In their inbox, they'll see a shipment. They can right-click that shipment and save it to the database. They can choose the folder to save it to, for example, Received Electronically, and then click OK. So here we have the master shipment. If we expand it, we have all the master level documentation and the two houses, each with its own documentation. If we go to the master level charges, we notice there's no charges. If you remember from our configuration, the reason they don't see our charges is because we didn't enable these two options. So now back in their database, they can perform functions such as a warehouse receipt reception and releases. Or if they don't have a warehouse, they can just set it to received and then set to delivered. In this example, we'll set the master to received, and then we can go to the first house, click on actions, and set that house to delivered. Notice when we go to the events tab, we have all the events. We can also go to the delivery tab and update POD information. We can update POD information either manually or using the Final Mile app by going to the task button, clicking create task, and selecting the task type delivery. In this example, we'll just update it manually. We'll enter the date and time and who received it. Then we'll update some comments and click the Update Origin button. Now let's go back to our database. Here's our database with the master. If you see our master status, it says it has been received at the Magaya Network user. Now let's go to the house and you see this one has been delivered. If we go to the Events tab, we see all the events. Now let's go to the Delivery tab, and all of the POD information is here. Notice in this example, we didn't update the second house, so let's go look at that. If you notice, there's no POD information, and the event shows that it has not been delivered yet. Also, the General tab shows it has been received, but has not been delivered yet. As you can see, the Magaya Network is a very powerful tool for connecting Magaya Network users. This video showed you the Magaya Network, and how to send warehouse receipts and shipments through the Magaya Network. Check out the knowledge base for step-by-step articles you can print or email to help you use the software fully. Thanks for watching.